Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to explain you about design of plate girder by using end stiffeners and avoiding intermediate stiffeners. In my previous video I just explained you about plate girder without using stiffeners, but here we are using end stiffeners but not intermediate stiffeners. Okay, moment was given and shear force was given in page number 63, class number 8.6.1, design of beams and plate girder with solid webs. There are some specifications are there, nothing but serviceability requirements, that is d by tw, that is thickness of web greater than 200 epsilon, and d by tw less than or equal to 67. If suppose condition is like this, intermediate transfer stiffeners are to be provided. If the condition is like this, end stiffeners will be provided, intermediate stiffeners did not to provide it, but thick webs are required. Like that the code is specifying. So by using these conditions we are going to design the plate girder, depth of the web. So here the given I'm trying k equal to d by tw, that equal to 100. So economical depth equal to formula mk by fy whole power 1 by 3. I converted this root 3 as whole power 1 by 3, m value which is given in equation, moment, and k value we know that is 100, by fy is yield stress 250. So I got this value. Now we are going to provide the 1200 mm wide plates which is near to this value, and I'm substituting this value in this equation. So 1200 by thickness of the web we don't know, so 1200 by tw equal to 100. I got thickness of the web as 12 mm. After that we are providing 12 mm plates for the web. So actually this is our plate girder, I section girder. This is the web portion and these two are flanges. So this is 1200 mm we are using now, depth and 12 mm thickness. Okay, after that we are going to calculate flanges. Now we calculated a web and now we are going to calculate flange. For this flange we need to calculate area value. So assuming only flanges resist moment, here the flanges only resisting moment we are assuming. So the formula is area of the flange into yield stress by yield stress into d by partial safety factor equal to 4233.6 into 10 power 6. Why? Because we are assuming only flanges resist the moment, that's why we are equating this to moment. So we are going to calculate area of the flange. I got this value. After that we need to calculate whether it is a plastic category, like that. So in table number 2, b by TF less than or equal to 8.4. This is one condition. So thickness of the flanges are, there are two flanges. Already I told you, this is one flange and this is another flange. So there are two flanges are there. That's why I wrote it as 2 into TF. So B by 2 into TF equal to 8.4. So B equal to 16.8 into TF we get. So area of the flange equal to L into B. So L is 16.8 into TF into B is thickness of the flange. I got TF equal to 30.4 mm. Okay, because area of the flange, we need to calculate thickness of the flange. Already we know the area of the flange. Area of the flange is 15523 mm. So I am equating this with area. Sorry, area of the flange is this one. So TF equal to 30.4 mm. So I am taking 36 mm plates. So B equal to 15523 by 36. I got 431 mm. So use 440 mm wide and 36 mm thick plates for flange. Previously we calculated web. Now this is flange. See this. This is 440 mm wide and 36 mm thick plates. This is 36 mm thick. So like that we are going to calculate these flange plates. Yeah, I'll show here. This is 440 and this is 36. This is 1200 total and 12 mm thickness. Okay, this is the ZZ axis. After this, we are going to calculate checks, adequate checks. So these are check for moment capacity. Since it is a plastic section, MD equal to the formula ZPFY by 1.1 less than or equal to 1.2 ZEFY by 1.1. This value, this formula is available in code book. Already in previous, in my previous problems, I mentioned in so many. Okay, by using this formula, we are going to calculate the ZP, I mean plastic categories, all these values. So here ZP, that is area 36 into 440. I'll show you 36 into 440 into yield stress 250 by 1.1. I got this value. Assuming only flanges resist moment. So moment of inertia IZZ formula. IZZ formula is, we know that BD cube by 12 plus A into YC square. So BD cube by 12 means nothing but IXX. Okay. For rectangle portion, the formula, moment of inertia formula is BD cube by 12 plus IZZ, that equal to area into YC square. This is centroid. So here BD cube by 12, 440, D is 36. This is B and this is D, BD cube by 12 plus area 440 L into B and YC square. YC square nothing but centroid. So here this total is 1200. Half of this is 600. So we need to calculate from here to this center point. So up to here it is 600 and here to here it is 36 by 2. That's why I wrote it as 36 by 2. I got this value. After that, ZD equal to IZZ by Y max. I substitute all the values. I got this value. And another condition is 1.2 into ZDFY by gamma M0. Here 1.2 into ZDFY by gamma M0 is 1.1. So I substitute all the values. I got this value. And the MD value is 449.6 kilonewtons meter greater than M. Hence it is okay. Next, shear resistance of the web. And we are going to calculate the shear resistance of the web, which is specified in code book. That is page number 59. It is available. Page number 59, clause number 8.4.2. D by TW greater than 67. Okay, this is in this clause number 8.4.2, it is available. After that, we are going to calculate here. Hence, resistance to shear buckling should be verified by using this clause. Consider simple post-critical method. In the clause 8.4.2.2, page number 59, we are considering the simple post-critical method. In this, we need to calculate the formula. So many formulas are there. So here, the first I am going to calculate tau CR. If you refer the code book, the formula will be available. Tau CR, that equal to that is web portion we are going to calculate. I'll show you. This is tau CR value. Okay, by using this formula we are going to calculate. So here tau CR equal to kv value available in code book, pi square e. And all these values are available in code book. Okay, by substituting all these values, mu value is 0.3 and 1200 is depth of that web, thickness of that web 12. Okay, by using these values we are going to calculate tau CR. After calculating this tau CR, we need to calculate the lambda W. So lambda W is nothing but non-dimensional web slenderness ratio for buckling stress. This is also given in page number 60. So root over FYW by root 3 tau CR. This is nothing but slenderness ratio formula, lambda W for the web, non-dimensional web slenderness ratio. So FY is nothing but yield stress 250 root 3 into tau CR value we calculated. I got 1.22. Next, since it is more than 1.2, its value 1.20. Page number 60, it mentioned that tau b. Tau b is nothing but shear stress corresponding to the web. Here the clause mentioned that when the lambda w value, here this is tau b value, when lambda w less than or equal to 0.8, we need to calculate this. When it is 0.8, lambda w less than 1.2, we need to calculate this, and lambda w greater than or equal to 1.2, we need to calculate this. Like that, in page number 60 the code specified this. So I choose tau b equal to fy by root 3 lambda w square. Okay, so I got this value, after that vcr equal to ab into tau b. ab we know that area. Okay, vcr shear force corresponding to the web buckling. Here the formula is available, vcr ab into tau b. So I calculated ab is area, that is l into b, 1200 into 12, and tau b is 96.97. I got this value. Ultimately we are going to calculate the VD value. So VD, that is VD is nothing but VN by gamma m naught. So VN is nothing but VCR, VD is nothing but a shear design strength. This is ultimate design strength we are going to calculate, which is available in page number 59, clause number 8.4, clause number, and page number 59. So VD equal to VN by gamma m naught. VN equal to VCR, here it is mentioned in simple post critical method, VN equal to VCR. Okay, shear buckling design methods. So we choose simple post critical method. I substitute all the values. I got 1269.49 kilonewtons, which is greater than our shear force, given shear force. Hence the force is 705 and the strength is more than the force, hence the strength is adequate. And next, local capacity of the web we are going to calculate. In page number 67 he mentioned the formula. Okay, and clause number 8.7.4, fw equal to b1 plus n2 thickness of the web, yield stress by gamma m naught. So here strip bearing length b1 we are assuming is 0, and n2 2 into 2.5 into 36. Okay, if you see 6.7, one diagram is there, here he mentioned clearly. So 2 into 2.5 into 36, that equal to 180, and thickness of the web is 12 and yield stress is 250 by 1.1. I got 490.909 10³, less than 705.6 kilonewtons. Hence end stiffener should be provided. Why? Because actually here the condition is okay, but here when comes to web the condition is not satisfied. Our force is 705 and our strength is less than the force. That's why we are going to provide end stiffeners. I'll show you the detailing part. End stiffeners is nothing but, this is the plate girder, I section plate girder, this is the elevation part. So here this is the end stiffeners. Okay, but here another stiffeners also there, that is intermediate stiffeners. In this we are not providing intermediate stiffeners. End stiffeners is nothing but these two are end stiffeners. Okay, why? Because our local capacity web condition was not satisfied, that's why we are providing end stiffeners to adequate the proper strength. After that we are going to design end stiffeners. Here design of end stiffeners are there. So outstand of flanges, outstand of flanges is nothing but the connection, I mean if the plate was not connected, that comes under outstand of flanges. So total wide of the flange is 440 minus 12 is thickness by 2. Outstand is nothing but flange is like this, this total is 440. Okay, I'm detecting this part, 440 minus 12, and we need this center by 2. That's why 440 minus 2, 12 is thickness. Outstand is, this is the outstanding portion, 12. So we got 214 mm. After that, try two numbers of 200 into 12 mm flats. Flats is nothing but these plates. So I got 214. I am taking as 200. Now the code is specifying that in class number 8.7.1.2, page number 65, 14 times the thickness of the flange we need to consider. This is the clause. So that's why I took it as 14 × 12. 168 mm I got. So, and the code is specifying, and one other thing, the outstand from the face should not exceed 20 times the thickness of the web. Here, that's why I wrote it like this. This is the plate girder and this is the stiffeners. This is the thickness of the web. Okay, the I section, I draw it in a reverse mode. Okay, 20 times the thickness of the web, that is specified in page number 65. This is the one condition. That's why 20 times the thickness of the web should not be exceeded. So here 168 mm we got. Total is 440 mm. And next, area for buckling resistance. So area for buckling resistance we need to calculate L into B, that is 2 × 168 and 168 plus 20 × 12. This is L and this is B. L into B into 12. Okay, 12 is nothing but thickness, this one. So I got 6912 mm². After that, we need to calculate moment of inertia, that is BD cube by 12 plus BD cube by 12. So B value is 12. First, I am calculating one portion, that is flange portion, and next web portion. So 12 into and D cube, that is depth 168 plus 12 plus 168 whole cube by 12, BD cube by 12. After that, again, I am calculating this one, 20 into 12. Into D cube is 12 cube by 12. Okay, I got this value. Next, R value, that is root over I by A. I is nothing but moment of inertia, we calculated. A is area, also we calculated. I got this value. And next, lambda equal to, code is specifying that 0.7 times L by R. So L value we know that 1200 × 78.12. L is nothing but depth of that web. So I got 10.757. according to a table 9c page number 42, we are going to calculate FCD value, that is design compressive stress. So here I took directly, I got 10.757, but here without doing interpolation, I mean, I'll show you the values in codebook. Table 9c, design compressive stress FCD value we need to calculate. Okay, so here the KL by R value is 10, but our value is 10.7. So I took it as 10, and for yield stress 250, the FCD value is 227. That's why I wrote it as 227. Okay, after calculating this, I simply calculated buckling resistance. That is 227 × 6912, that is area. I got 1569.02, which is greater than our shear force. Hence, the stiffener is safe. Next, the same process. Check for bearing capacity of the stiffener. Previously, we calculated the web capacity. Now, we are calculating the stiffener capacity. In page number 68, class number 8.7.52, the formula is given. And I substitute all the values. AQ value, that is area, we know that. Here I calculated area of the stiffener in contact with flange. So 2 × 200 × 12 I got. Why? Because there are two flanges are there, and area L into B, 200 × 12. I got 4800 mm². I substitute all the values in this equation. I got this value, which is greater than shear force. Hence, the stiffener is okay. Next, check for torsional resistance provided by stiffener. Now, we are calculating all the checks for stiffeners. So, in page number 68, the formula is available. So, IS less than or equal to 0.34 alpha S D cube TCF. So, here, I by first we are going to calculate, that is BD cube by 12 plus BD cube by 12. So I got this value 511.277 into 10^6 mm square. After that, I'm going to calculate the area. That is, we know that 36 is thickness of that portion and 440 is the width of that portion, flange portion. And 1200 into 12, that is web portion. Why? Because the stiffener is attached like this. If suppose this is the I section, okay, the stiffener is provided in this area, so it is included in flange and web portion. So that's why we are calculating both the areas. And next, R by value, I by A, I value we know that, A value we know that. And next, lambda, that is 24 L by R value. Lambda equal to L by R. L is nothing but 24 meters span, which is given in question, and 24 by meters in given, that's why I wrote it as 1000 in mm. So 105.3, that is R value. I got 227.92. After calculating this, I'm substituting alpha is equal to 30 by lambda square, which is given in page number 68. This alpha is equal to 30 by lambda square. So I'll show you in page number 68. He mentioned that how we are going to take the alpha s value. He mentioned so many values in page number 68 here. Alpha is equal to 0.006 and 0.3 by LLT by RY, nothing but lambda, and 30 by LLT by RY. Why? Because why I took this? Because our value is greater than 100. So I took this 30 by lambda square. This is nothing but LLT by RY, is nothing but lambda value. So our value, we got more than 100. So that's why I took the value. In page number 68, it is available. So after calculating this, I substitute all the values in this equation. I got this value. And this IS is nothing but second moment of area of stiffener about XX axis. Okay. For that, we are going to calculate, that is BD cube by 12, the formula, same formula. Okay. This is the second moment of inertia formula. So I calculated all the values. I got IS, which is greater than 14.5548 into 10^6. Hence the torsional resistance is sufficient. After calculating this, we are going to calculate the connections. Connections, we already know that. Here we are going to calculate welding connection, shear force, which is given, IZ value we know that in previously we calculated, and shear stress V by B into IZ AY bar formula. V value, we know that B is 440 into 2 into IZ is 440 into 2 means two flanges are there, and the B is width of that flange portion 440, and two flanges are there. That's why I wrote it as 2. And IZ value we calculated already. So A is area 36 into 440, and Y bar is 618. 618 is nothing but our web portion depth is 1200. And this one is 36, thickness of the flange. So Y bar means nothing but centroid. This is 600 from here to here, and this is centroid means up to here, that is 18 plus 18, 36. So total 600 plus 18, 618. So I got this value. And if size of the weld is yes, and if it is provided on both sides of both, okay, and the welding is providing on both sides, side of the web, page number 79, clause number, in this clause, strength of the weld per unit length formula is available. FWD equal to FWN by gamma MW. FWN is nothing but FU by root 3. After doing this, we are going to calculate the formula by using that formula. 2 into 0.78s, 410 is ultimate strength of the plate by root 3. 1 by 1.25 partial safety factor. I got 265.1 into S Newton per mm. And I am equating with this shear force. S equal to 2.416 mm. But as per code, the code is specifying that for 12 mm plates, minimum size of the weld to be used is 5 mm. In table number 21, this clause is mentioned. So that's why we are going to calculate percentage of welded length required, that is 2.416 by 5 into percentage is nothing but 100. So I got 48.3. We are providing 50% weld. Okay. And next, minimum length of intermittent welds we need to provide, that is 40 mm. In clause number, in this clause, page number 79, the code is specifying that that minimum is 40 mm. That's why I am providing 40 mm length with 5 mm weld on both sides. So after that, weld connecting stiffener and web. Here we calculated for the flanges and web, and here we are calculating for stiffener and web. Here the formula is D into T cube by 12, nothing but BD cube by 12 formula, and A equal to L into B D into T thickness of the web. R equal to root over I by A, radius of gyration equal to I by A, moment of inertia by area. So area formula here, and I formula is here. After that I calculated thickness of web by root 12, I got it. So KL equal to 0.7 times the D, which is specified in code. So lambda equal to KL by R. So K value is 0.7 into D, R value is this one. So I substituted all the values here, and I got the lambda value as 242. Nothing but lambda value equation is 2.42 D by thickness of the web. Here D equal to 1200 mm, that is web depth of the web, and thickness of the web is 12 mm thickness. So I got 242. After calculating these values, we are going to choose N1 equal to D by 2. Why? Because we are going to calculate the stiff bearing, weld connecting web stiffener and web. Okay, N1 equal to D by 2. So D is, total depth is 1200 plus 2 into 36. That is, two flanges are there. Two flanges depth is 36 by 2, 636 mm. In table 9C, we are going to calculate FCD value by using interpolation. Okay. So 26 point, already in my previous video I told you that how to calculate this interpolation. So I got FCD design compressor stress 25.82 Newton per mm square. By using FY yield stress, we are going to calculate in table 9C, this FCD value is available. And assuming I am stiff bearing B1 equal to 0, which is not given in question, that's why I am assuming as 0. Area of web resisting shear, B into TW, L into B. So I got this value. Load directly transferred by the web. So here, while applying load, that is transferred by the web directly. So 636 into 12, this one, and FCD. I got 197.08 kilonewtons. And next, shear to be transferred through weld. That is nothing but, if the I section is like this, our girder is like this, the shear is directly transferred through weld. Here the welding portion is there, here the welding portion is there. Okay, and nothing but shear force minus load directly transferred by the web. So I got shear force is this one, and load directly transferred by the web is 197.08. Okay, this formula is nothing but stress equal to load by area, we know that. Okay, here load equal to area into stress. Area is this one, and stress is design compressive stress is this one. That's why I wrote like this. I got 508.52 kilonewtons. And length of the weld. Length of the weld is, total depth of the web is 1200 minus 2 into 12. 2 into 12 is nothing but thickness of the web. Two sides we are doing the welding. That's why 2 into thickness of this web. I got this value. Shear to be transferred. So shear to be transferred equally. So 508.52 divided by 1176. For here we are transferring the shear to the length of the weld. So that's why equally we need to transfer. So I got 0.432 kilonewton per mm. to this additional shear of, we need to add it. In code book, it is mentioned that TW square by 5BS is to be added. Okay, this one is to be added. This formula is available in code book. So 12 into 12 by 5 into 200. After calculating this, total design shear for the weld, that is 0.432 plus 0.144. I got this value. After calculating this, again, strength of the weld we need to calculate by using the same formula. 2 into 0.7 S into Fu by root 3 into 1 by partial safety factor. I got this value. And again, I am equating with this force. S equal to 2.6. As per table 21, the code is specifying that the minimum size of the weld is 5 mm for 12 mm plates and the percentage of welding is 52.4. I got, so I am providing 55% weld. And the final design is for the plate girder, web portion is 1200 mm by 12 mm web 1 and flange is 440 by 36 mm and end stiffness is 200 by 12 mm. So here the plate girder detailing is there. This is elevation part. The span of this plate girder is 24 meters. These are the end stiffeners. And this is the elevation part. Here total web is 1200 mm. And thickness of the flange is 36 mm. And this is 440 mm. And thickness of this web is 12 mm. And this one is the welding portions. Okay, this is the elevation view. Nothing but the side view. So here we can observe easily that is this end stiffener. Okay, so these are used in mostly used in bridges, heavy bridges. I hope you understood this. In my next video, I'm going to upload by using intermediate stiffeners how we are going to calculate the plate girder design. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.